We are back in the pool house today. We are determined to make progress out here. You can really forget about this renovation project because it's not part of the main house. But now that pool season is basically here, we need to get it up and running because we just want to make life cozy for our guests. So our first mission is to get this bathroom up and going because that's the main thing. People need to go to the bathroom so they don't pee in your pool. Just kidding. But so we really want to get this done. We're working on the crown molding today, and then hopefully we can paint, put the flooring in, get the toilet in, because really, as long as the bathroom's running, this kitchen area can come next, but it's not as vital as the bathroom. So there is still a tub in the kitchen area. So today, this guy and I, we are working through our frustrations and deciding what furniture pieces we're going to use. So the problem that we are trying to solve today is what is going to go on this back wall and what purpose that is going to serve. So cabinetry, an antique piece of furniture, shelving, and then where the sink is going to go. So the sink was supposed to be centered right here, but we're starting to think that the kitchen sink might go here. And then we need a place for the fridge and everything. The problem that we have is that we like to use antique pieces of furniture, but those are already set to a certain size, obviously. So we want an island, and we're wondering if we should do a dining table island or a piece with storage. So in short, we are trying to sort through our options today. Do we put a dining table in the middle and put like an antique shelf piece back here and the sink over there, or do we do an island, an actual island, sink, antique piece, actual island, build our own piece back here and put the sink there still and have that be opened? Because another option for a dining area is to do like a built-in bench back here with like a circle table and some chairs. Just for when we want to use the space, like in the winter, or when it starts raining, or just want to hang out inside, get out of the sun. There's so many options. It's almost like too many, if you know what I mean. So we're just really trying to sort through that today, do the pros and the cons, and decide because we can't make any moves until we make those big decisions. It's so funny because most of our house has just been kind of acting as a storage unit, and we just try to make it look pretty. So this piece was never supposed to be back here, but we moved it back here because it fit. But we believe 95% sure that this will be the island, this antique drawer piece in the pool house. So we are 95% sure this is the island. So we'll move this out there eventually. We're gonna need help. It's a heavy girl, but I don't know what will go here. But we're basically storing pieces here in our garage at the store, and we do have a small storage unit as well. So during these renovations, we're just trying to make things work. And I'm using it as an opportunity to share more ideas with you guys in my feed on the blog. So hopefully during the renovations, I can still be a source of inspiration. Don't mind the mess in the greenhouse. I have not been doing much in here this season yet. So there's a mess. We've been playing house in here, but that's about it. It's kind of a mess. Anyways, we're thinking this sink in there. We're trying to use items that we already own. So we're thinking this sink in the pool house kitchen. I believe we have one or two of these. We might have one in the barn as well that we've collected over time. We've had this one for many years, 5 years, 4 years. So I might move this sink into the pool house kitchen, but it will be one like this to give you an idea. Like I said earlier, nothing in this house is where it's going to be, but I wrote about this in my first book, and I will scream it at the top of my lungs every single day, just in case someone needs to hear it. You can make your home cozy in the in-between. So we have to shuffle things so much during these renovations. Soon we'll be moving this entire staircase, and this cabinet is at the top of the staircase. But for now, you best believe I'm gonna put a cabinet at the top of the stairs and fill it with some kitchen finds, because our kitchen is ripped up. I mean, it's just making it cozy in the in-between, making it happy in the in-between. And so I actually put a lot of my antique finds from the weekend, I put them here in this cabinet. And what I did was I sorted through my white book collection. You guys know at one time I filled an entire library with antique white books. And I sorted through those, and I'm gonna be bringing a bunch to the store. So if you need white books, I'll have them at the store soon, but I'll share that with you. Also, one of my dreams was to own a shop. And I will say, it is not easy being a shop owner, a small shop owner. It's not easy. Is it worth it? Yeah, it's definitely worth it. And I love it. And it's just, one of the reasons why I love it and I will forever own a shop in some capacity, hopefully it's the Found Cottage forever, is that with like my antique finds and things like that, I can style them and use them at home, and then I can bring them to the shop and I don't need to hoard absolutely everything. And one of the things was, for a while there, we had a library and I filled it with white books, and now I don't need all the white books. So I sorted through them yesterday, and I am going to be bringing a lot of my white spine books to the Found Cottage. So if you're like me, I suggest getting like a booth space or following your dreams and opening a store. As an antique collector and enthusiast, I think who shares just bits of her life online, I sometimes think it gets a little confusing to people that follow or just stop in and they're like, wait, last week you had an antique collection of white books, and then this week you did something different. And I think they just like picture, like, I don't know, a barn filled with antiques or like a basement, and which, you know, that's not a lie. But being a shop owner, it and someone who uses their house as a creative palette to share online and give ideas, I will get a lot of antiques and I will keep some forever. And sometimes I will shuffle some out and bring them to the store. So it's just one of the parts of what I do, being an antique collector, an antique dealer, and a creative that shares online. So I hope that helps some of you. But if you like these little guys up here, I thrifted those little boxwood and pots. And, you know, our house is like just in shambles. You know, I have pretty corners like this that keep me cozy and hopeful. But I thrifted those and I've been like, you know what, I don't know if I need those. So I will bring them to the shop, or I will keep them. I haven't decided yet, but that's just an example. But if you are someone who likes what I do as far as like sharing ideas online with my home and collecting antiques and, you know, going to flea markets, things like that. If you've ever considered getting like a booth, that's how I started. And it let me cycle through a lot of like my antiques. Like I would go and thrift them and work hard and collecting them. I would style them and keep some forever. I've had some for 10 plus years. And then some of them I would shuffle through. So just an idea and a little glimpse at what I do. Two more things that I will not be keeping for myself are these two fruit topiaries. We talked about these a lot last week, and I did that DIY one, but basically to keep my collection down and curated, consolidated, and not turning into a hoarder, I have a specific kind that I'll be collecting now, and these ones do not fit that criteria. So I will be bringing these to the Found Cottage. I was so excited when I found them. And yeah, I just think they're really cool. So I'm excited to see them go to someone else's home. I'm excited to style them in the shop and see what someone else does with them. I love this one, like how worn it is. I might try another DIY and then do it with like some aging wax or something to give it a similar look. So yeah, I'll keep you guys posted, but these are heading to the Found Cottage. A little kitchen update for you. I have no update. I want to promise you again, every day we get inundated with messages like, what's happening in there? I promise you, everything is in the highlights, and I will update as soon as something happens. Nothing has happened in here since the brick. And finding the windows. But again, this is all on the blog, and also it can all be found in the highlights. So everything will always be on the blog and in the highlights, because sadly, stories expire. But since the window update that we found those, the brick, and the stove and all that, which, you know what, I'm going to bring Jose in here and explain the stove and why, by the way, that has its own highlight as well, but why it hasn't been named yet. I don't like to place blame on others, and I'm very self-aware, but I do want to share the blame on this one, and I'll just explain why. So we got everything ourselves, like drywalled and done to the point where we wanted to do it, and our builder is on another project. And then when he comes back, we'll be able to progress farther. We really, since it's kind of like a, not a final renovation, but a more serious one, we did want to ask for more help this time. So we're doing what we want to do. And then structurally, we have someone coming in. But anyways, I lied. I do kind of have an update, but I'm not ready to share it because I don't have them here. I did find the doors for the butler pantry. And very exciting news, we accidentally created a place for pocket doors on both sides. So we can do pocket doors on the butler pantry now. So we don't have to have the doors open into the butler pantry or out. So they'll be able to be slim, which is really exciting. And I'll share those when I get them. So self-awareness is that I'm always late for everything. And I always tell people like, hey, I'll like pick that tomorrow. Pick two winners. It's always going to be the day later. So just know that. I'm not proud of it. But anyways, I shared a reel like a week ago. A week. I don't know. Anyways, it's been a while. I said, let's pick a name tomorrow. Then it was like, let's pick a name the next day. And I've been taking all the blame for it. I'll share the reel next. And I do. I never want to pass the blame, but I want to share the blame with this one.
Thank you.
Because every day I'm like, Jose, we have to pick a name because we're going to pick two Stanley winners. We haven't done that yet for the AGA. This guy cannot decide.
It's so like, it's not permanent, but like, I feel like it's permanent.
He feels so much pressure. Like it's, we didn't feel like this naming Copeland.
Like we should have him name it.
Honestly, we should.
Yeah. Pick a name.
Over the past week, when it seems like we're just not picking a name, we've had a few discussions and thoughts about the name.
Yeah, I, but like, so
very deep conversation.
So like Agatha is, I think, was the most popular one. Love the name.
But I feel so like creative.
Anyone that names their Aga probably came up with that. There's probably a lot of Agathas out there.
Fun fact, I didn't think of the name and I didn't even get it right away. I'm like, oh, Agatha is a great name. And then I read it and I was like, oh.
But like, I don't know. It's so like, like, do you hint on like, in here, like,
he's very connected.
The cream, do you, I mean,
I know
cooker, I don't, do you dial into the cooker name and use like a C name? Does it have
is
to
she
be
gonna
an
be
a?
Mad about the name you pick, you yeah. know, like how does she feel? So anyways, I think I'm gonna involve Cope, and I'm gonna ask Cope.
Yeah,
he named a cat this weekend
Sharky,
and I was like,
I love it.
Where did that come from? We never talk about sharks, and it's the cutest name ever. So maybe that's the missing piece.
Yeah,
we'll keep Cope. You posted.
This is your vibe. I want to be friends.
If I could mail my heart right to you, I would. I'd pack it up. See you.
Okay, I am so nervous and excited because so many of you are getting your cozy deck in the mail. Yesterday, Instagram glitched, and so I went to go share a bunch of you who got it for free at the Springfield Extravaganza in Cotton Shed's booth. I put a bunch in there for you guys to go and grab free. Thank you so much for sharing those and sharing your excitement over them. I hope you truly enjoy them. I wanted to share one idea that I did with them this weekend. I always collect these little displays here. This is an antique find. And before I just had these silhouettes on them, and I was like, what a fun way to like pick a few of my current favorites as like pretty reminders to put here on my desk. Like just cozy tip reminders and a great way to display them. So if you collect anything like this, I usually find them at flea markets, antique shops, little displays. What a cool way to display your cozy reminders. Right now I picked the tea towel art, the ad legs, the DIY faux fireplace, and the cloches for my display. But when I'm sitting here working or needing inspiration, I think it's a great way to display the cards. And so if you got a deck, you ordered one from the Found Cottage, they should be arriving in the mail. I will leave the link here. We have them released first at the Found Cottage, and then I believe next Tuesday, they will release for everybody, so not just our small shop. But thank you for supporting our small shop and celebrating the release there first. That means so much. I will also leave the pre-order link for you if you choose to order them that way. Either way, thank you. And if you think this deck can help you find cozy, please get it. But if the books are good for you or just my tips online, don't feel any pressure. It's just another way to get it.